Hey everyone, welcome to episode 30 of the PC World Show. This is your home for tough talk about the most interesting tech topics of the week. And we're recording this show on October 5th. And I have executive editor Gordon Ma-ung.
Hello.
Hey Gordon, what's up? And executive editor Jason Cross. Hey Jason.
Hello.
Hey.
How's it going?
Good, how are you? And I'm John Phillips, editor-in-chief. So we got a lot of stuff to cover today. Yesterday was the big Google event, so we're going to talk about the Pixel phones and then move to VR and then Google Home. And then Gordon's going to tell us all about Kaby Lake, which we have in the form of a laptop part, for starters, and that's what he's going to get into. And then finally, we'll close the show with, I have a question about Google's smartphone fortunes and where they could be in a year from now. Then as usual, we're recording this live on Facebook and we're going to be answering some Facebook questions as we go along. But let's start with the Pixel phone. So Jason and I were at the event and we both got to play with them. But let's just talk about first impressions. So Jason, why don't you jump in?
I think it's a really nice phone. I don't think it's gonna like outsell the Samsung Galaxy S7 or something right away. And it's certainly not throwing every single feature you could possibly put into a phone like Samsung does. You know, it's not waterproof and wireless charging and stuff. But it is, it looks really good. It feels really good, really premium. It's got nice exclusive features. And, you know, I think if they had called it a Nexus, I think we would say, hey, this is the nicest Nexus they've ever made.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, I would agree. The lack of waterproofing does seem like a strange omission. I don't know why they couldn't tackle that one. And I never minded, and I don't mind camera bumps on the Nexus 6P or the iPhone, but they did eliminate that. So the top half of the phone has that sheet of glass. So that's cool. And it was super fast. So the interface was quick. It felt like a really zippy, fluid phone. And of course, the camera app was, I know that was a gripe of yours in the past, and that seems to have been fixed as well, where it snaps, whether it's in burst mode or single shot mode. It's super fast. The camera app launches really quickly. And though obviously we haven't had a chance to test the camera quality, they're making a lot of noise about how that will look.
Yeah, so I mean, that's the kind of thing you got to mess with yourself for a little while, but it seems like things like the focus time, it seems like they eliminated the shutter lag, and its ability to take one shot after another is a lot better than it was on the Nexus 6P. So, I mean, they said twice as fast, but they were way behind the competition. So, you know, I don't know, is it going to beat Samsung or something? I don't know, but it seems at first blush, it seems like up there in the top tier of best camera phones, you know, so.
Right.
I got a question though. I'm a little confused. I thought, you know, because obviously everybody's got optical image stabilization now. Does the new Pixel phone have OIS, or isn't all electronic?
No, it's a new all electronic thing. Their own new custom algorithm that samples the gyroscope and stuff super fast, and is supposed to smooth stuff out that way. So.
And the demo and they showed on stage still shots, looked pretty good for video.
Yeah, we weren't able to recreate anything that dramatic. The demo they showed on stage was super dramatic, and we weren't able to make it stabilize like that. But, you know, we'll try it out. We'll see if it's really all that good. But it's got a huge sensor with huge pixels, and I guess they think they don't need OIS or they couldn't fit it.
Yeah.
This seems like a pretty big oversight because as somebody who's been in this still photography for a long time, optical immunization is just always been so much better than electronic stabilization. That is
been around forever. They don't care how they get there. They just want to give you a clean shot. And so
the electronic stuff on like DSLRs and stuff is always been garbage. Like the phone stuff's already been better than that. So you know, we'll see.
And what was
we'll have to try it.
I can't remember the exact details, but it was either HDR or a different kind of shot where they take a whole bunch and then they pick the best shot out of a row of photos. Is that, I'm trying to remember.
There's a burst mode they've had on the Nexus 6P and stuff where you just hold down the shutter it snaps off a gazillion photos, and it kind of picks the best one, but you can go through and look at them all and pick the best one. Right. And then their HDR mode does what a lot of other cameras' HDR modes do, including the iPhone and stuff. It snaps a couple of pictures back to back and sort of at different exposures and combines them. And Google's algorithm for that is really, really smart about like finding if there's been any motion in the between the two photos and like eliminating blurring and stuff like that. And so they've also always had a really good algorithm for that.
And if you buy the phone, so this is a Pixel exclusive, you get unlimited uncompressed storage for photos and video. So that's another, you know, reason that that's, you know, not a hardware feature, but it is a reason why people might consider this a really good camera phone.
I guess although when are they going to take it one step further on that, on analyzing the photos? Cause if they're going through analyzing your HDR photos and tossing the bad ones, when are they going to actually have a filter that just tosses bad photos? Like if they just analyze it and say, no, this photo is no good. And it deletes it for you automatically.
Yeah.
No, like, you know, like, no, bad photo. Would that be funny?
It just there should be a setting for that.
It would be funny.
Yeah, it was just a bad photo. No, unacceptable. Try again.
Or, you know, the way Google sort of analyzes the content of all your photos, it'd be neat if you could say, hey, show me my best photos from my vacation.
Yeah,
and it could just
but
pick the ones that were really good.
This photo is unacceptable.
No. Yeah, and I think you're right, Gordon. There should be an option where you could. I mean, maybe it shouldn't do it automatically, but you should be able to voluntarily click that option to kill those crappy photos.
I bet they could really easily identify stuff that's just all blurry, like you were moving or something, you know, and just scrap those as an option. I bet that would not be that hard for Google to do.
So what do you guys think about Google Assistant? So, you know, it's already an Allo, and in a lot of ways, it just seems like a more convenient way to access Google Now. So it seems really cool, but I don't use Google Now right now to start text messaging conversations or to find photos. You know, I just use it to find information. So is there a lot of difference here, or is it just better packaging of an existing feature?
I feel like it's mostly just what's at Google Now, sort of repackaged in a way to make it more conversational. But I never see them demo something where I'm like, man, Google Now just doesn't do that at all.
Yeah.
Maybe it does a half step and there it's a little more complete in Assistant, but it just doesn't seem
right.
I'm glad that it's taken out of Allo because Google Now does things to like device control and stuff. Like you can tell it to set an alarm and do all this other stuff that I don't think it does when it's within Allo, I think, because it's a messaging app.
Sure.
I'm confused. I mean, it's like there's like a multiple personality thing in a Google phone, because you know Siri, you know Cortana, it's one damn personality, right? But like, so am I talking to OK Google? Am I talking to Google Now? Now we got Assistant, got Allo. I just want to tell the phone to do something.
You're talking to
they're
Google.
They're all OK Google.
I know, but like, why not? What the hell? I mean, is it?
Do you want it to be a person? Do you want it to be Alexa or Siri or Cortana?
It should be something that I understand, because like, oh, it's Assistant. So is that Google? Is that Google Now? Is that Allo?
I think they want to brand it Google. And the message from yesterday is they want everything branded Google. Like Google is the place where you get the world's data. And so they don't want you talking to some abstract, you know, sprite named Alexa or Siri. They want you talking to Google.
I guess I'm just confused, because it seems like it's fragmented even within Google, because it's like,
I don't think so. I mean, there's never been a name. It's always been OK Google.
Yeah, but so then what exactly is Assistant? What's the difference between OK Google and Assistant, though? I mean, what?
Well,
there is no difference. Assistant is the feature that you summon by saying OK Google. Like Google Now was the previous feature you summoned by saying, okay, Google. It's just all...
It's a technology. It's a technology that's built into Google Home and now into the phones.
I guess that's the confusing part, because I understand Siri is, you know, and Cortana, what they are. I don't understand, like, they keep calling these... They seem to be introducing new products, but it's the same thing. It's just we're making it smarter. We're making Google.
I do think it is confusing where you have Google Now and now you have Google Assistant. So and some people might be confused that there is a messaging app called Allo with Google Assistant built in. So, I mean, for we're sophisticated tech users, I think we could keep all these ideas in our head, but I could totally see how less sophisticated people.
Me.
Okay, you.
I mean, I'm not a phone guy, so.
Well, you use phones every day.
I know, but I have an S5, for God's sake.
I could see you going, well, isn't Allo Google Assistant? Well, no, it's really a messaging app.
Yeah, I think Google it'll get a little less confusing once they build, like they're building an SDK that for device manufacturers next year that'll let them build Assistant into all their products,
right,
other products. And that'll get a little less confusing because right now, if it's just built into one product, Allo, then you're like, well, is it Allo? Is it the Assistant or something? When there's a dozen different things with which you can summon the Google Assistant, then you kind of know what that is.
Yeah.
It's kind of like if you could summon Siri from 12 different things.
Right, like from CarPlay and from your phone, right. Sure.
Yeah.
Well, okay. I want to move on to Facebook questions or comments so we can keep this moving. But anything from Facebook, Adam?
Yeah, we got somebody asking about if they mentioned anything of the Project Aura. Was there any mention at the event yesterday?
No, it's dead.
Is it?
It's, yeah, not a word. And yeah. they essentially killed it. They said they're never going to productize it.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
So they're basically handed off the idea of a modular smartphone to its partners. Mm-hmm. And so if you want a modular smartphone, go to LG or Moto. That's it for now. And I think that's, so we're not just, this isn't conjecture, right? Wasn't that in the Verge article that we read this morning?
I don't remember.
I don't remember where I
read
it.
Them announcing a few weeks ago that, you know, or months. That okay. Project Aura is never, they're never going to be like putting out a Project Aura phone or thing. Those technologies will sort of get used by other partners or something, but there's never going to be a phone from Google, like a Project Aura phone or anything.
Right. They're focusing on real phones that people will buy and use.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that was a good question. So thanks for asking. Who asked that question? We should name check these people.
That was Soren.
Okay, cool. Thanks, Soren.